we've looked at a profile with a simple example with only one stack of things happening. If you remember when I was talking about the examples, I gave an example where things start to branch. And so this had three samples in my example, and we did this thing where A called B called C, and we started branching at this. So let me show you how we express that in code. So some simple JavaScript, we have the function A, which calls B. Now B goes and calls C and H, and then C calls D and F, and then D calls E and F and G all do a decent amount of work. But if you notice, what's kind of weird here is that F calls G, and then there's H here at the end, which calls F, and then we're going to finally execute A. So okay, that's like a tangled web. But I was trying to take our example of kind of the simple abstract example and then build code that would generate a call tree that looks like that, that has that type of stack relationship. So this will hopefully generate our tree for us. I'm going to go back over to Firefox, and I'm going to, again, my profile was still recording from the last time I did it, so I'm going to go ahead and discard and stop so that I have like a simple, clear example. I'm going to start it again, click here and refresh, and then I'm going to click back up to the add-on and click capture profile. We have a really big profile because I'm zoomed in. And like last time, there was that little red section that said, hey, we got slow here, there's some work going on. So filtering through all the threads and all the stuff going on, I'm going to click that one place and see it's content 3 of 3. So I'm going to do that same thing where I hide all the others. So I'm only looking at the thing I care about. Zoom in on it, and you can see, like, in my stack graph right here, this area looks like it's all doing kind of a similar thing, which is kind of a hint. And I go to my call tree, and it has all the C++ internals for this, and I only care about the JavaScript, so let's look at JS only. And we finally have this do work branched. And I'm going to kind of zoom in on that section so that our call tree is nice and clean for only the code that we care about and we can analyze it a lot better. So you can see A calls B calls C, but here you notice the interesting part. So A and B all have a running time of 290 milliseconds. So we have 290 samples that the profiler has collected of our stacks that both have A and B on it. But then you can see that C and H have a branching pattern. So these are two different paths of work that are going on. And we can start to read our call tree tells us information about this. So our running time now is 60% and 40% on these two different levels. So we can see if we're trying to optimize performance, like the first thing we want to look at is probably the 60% to see what's going on in here because it's taking the most time. And as I'm using the arrow keys, or I can click to kind of go between them. And what's nice is this thread stack graph at the top, the height of it doesn't equate to the amount of time spent. It equates to the size of the stack, which is just kind of an arbitrary thing, but it tells you a little bit about your code. So as I go through it, you can see 60% of the time here is in all these stacks, and then 40% is in the remaining. Let's go ahead and dive into the C stack. We go here, and now we can see, okay, 40% of the time is spent in F, which is organized higher, and then D, 20%, and F actually has some self time in it. So we actually spent time in F of 59 milliseconds, and then we also spent 58 milliseconds in G. So both of these functions had time where it was actually observed being running. That's because I had that for loop in both those functions. So even though G is the leaf most, F was still observed doing work. And you can go down and see H now, where all this happened as well. And I can navigate all this with keyboard shortcuts up and down, which is my preferred way to do it. Makes it nice and easy. But you can start to see if you're trying to like figure out where work is happening. I can see, oh, well, G is working on both these areas. So maybe I can go in and optimize this function, or you know, C, maybe I don't need a call in here. So it gives you the kind of the first step of being able to look at execution paths and the total sum of where time was spent for all of your samples that are you're observed. And kind of one final point that I want to show up here is that this is kind of like a probabilistic view into your application. And you can see the little ticks on the thread stack graph actually have little gaps between them. That's because they're all sized the same size, but it's, you know, it's the computers are firing signals in the background and doing stuff. That time is not quite precisely 1 millisecond between each. So you can see like little gaps in there. And that kind of explains what's going on with all that.